What's going on, guys? No, just checking in. Today I want to talk about confidence, or more specifically, the lack thereof that a lot of us feel like when we're depressed, anxious, or even if we're just coming out of depression and anxiety, depersonalization. Confidence is usually one of those things that has long since left us, especially if we're new to mood disorders. So my buddy Mark wrote me a nice message telling me what he's been going through, which is a lot, and my heart goes out to you, Mark. Please stay brave in your fight. But he tells me, in so many words, that he has no confidence left, not with his friends, not with his family, certainly not with the opposite sex, and he doesn't know how to get it back or what to do about it. And I have really simple advice. I really feel like my advice on this topic can be implemented by anyone. It doesn't require much effort, but what it does require is some honesty. And you guys would not believe what being honest can do for your confidence. Most of us choose, maybe it's just a default setting, but most of us choose to suffer in silence when we go through hardships, especially mood disorders, because of the stigma, because of our own insecurities, because of our lack of knowledge, because of the people around us, because of whatever. We tend to not really speak openly about what we're going through. But the truth is, most of us are going through something. Now, it varies in severity, of course, but when I was really, really, really depressed and I didn't know what was going on, I didn't know what to do, didn't know what to say, and I just holed up and isolated, and I felt even more alone. And then, of course, there's no confidence when you're severely depressed. But what I found is that when I could be honest, which is what I would invite you to do, Mark, and anyone else who may benefit, if you can just be honest about what you're going through, you wouldn't believe how much that opens other people up to be honest about what they're going through. And nothing makes you feel more confident than seeing someone else respond positively to your truth. It doesn't have to be a pretty thing. I mean, you could be all completely fucked up in the head, like I was and still am sometimes, I suppose. But if you can just say it like it is, honesty is refreshing. Honesty is just a wonderful universal language to all ears. And if someone can just believe that whatever it is you're going through, good, bad, or ugly, is actually what you're going through, maybe they'll want to talk about it too. And suddenly you don't have to feel so insecure. Suddenly, even though you don't feel well, you can find some confidence in the fact that people appreciate that sort of honesty. You know when someone asks you how you are and you respond, oh, I'm fine. The fuck? Sorry. That dog just scared the shit out of me. When people ask you how you are, a lot of people feel like they naturally just respond with some bullshit, cliche answer, like, oh, I'm fine, I'm doing okay. But if you're in a situation where you can actually surprise someone with some honesty and say, oh, I'm feeling really depressed and working through a lot of anxiety, but I'm hanging in there. If you can say that to people in an appropriate setting, I'm not saying say it to a complete stranger, but say it to someone who you feel comfortable enough with, like a friend, or even an acquaintance, surprise an acquaintance, or a family member, you wouldn't believe how most people respond. It's overwhelmingly positive. And they admire you, you know what I mean? And feeling some admiration from other people, even if it's just being honest about your struggle, it's a really, really good head start into feeling some confidence. I mean, of course you're still gonna feel like shit. Or of course you have a lot of self-discovery to do. You have a lot of work to do to feel more comfortable in life again after having been depressed. But in so many words, if you can just be honest about whatever it is that you're facing, it's going to slowly add to your stock of confidence. That, hey, look, and that's something that this channel has proved to me a million times over, is that no matter what I'm going through, if I can just tell you guys with sincerity and not bullshit you, to the best of my ability, of course, you guys usually respond with love and feedback and hope and community, and then you share. And that's what makes this channel, oh my God, priceless to me. Because I open up, and then so many of you open up, and suddenly we are not just individuals, but we become a group. And I think that's really important for confidence, is to feel like other people are broken just like you. And they are. Whether you believe it or not, they really are. I don't care what you're going through. Someone out there has your story. That's my tip for getting back your confidence. Just be real about what it is you're facing. Just tell the truth. That's it. And see what it does for you. You'd be surprised. Just trust me on this. You'd be surprised how good it'll make you feel, even if it's a negative happiness, meaning you'll feel less shitty. Just trust me, the confidence will creep back. And then pretty soon you'll be feeling good, over time, whenever that time may come for you. And when you feel good and you were able to just call it like it was when it was bad, it's gonna be that much easier to talk about things when they're better, and your confidence is gonna grow. There are, of course, many other little things you can do, but on a basic level, on a universal principle of honesty. I think it's going to help you. I hope that was worth something to you. Thank you so much for watching the video, guys. I appreciate you more than you'll ever know. We'll do another video soon. And just remember, whatever you're going through, I mean this, you can get through it. One day, 1 hour, 1 minute at a time, we can get through it together. All for one. We'll see you guys in the next video.